Hi everyone, my name is Alex and I have been secretary of this club from January to June. And being a club officer, I participated in meeting organization, and thus I clearly realize how much time, energy and resources does it take to organize a meeting. And today I'd like to speak about resources which we consume to prepare our handouts and to make some proposals for its optimization. All right, and I'd like to start with costs. Who of you knows how many new members do we need to register a new club?
20.
20. Okay. Let's imagine a club of 20 members. And based on my personal experience, to organize a meeting of such a club, we need 50 printing papers for one meeting. And if we speak about a year, we need 1,200 sheets of paper, of printing paper. And is this number big or not? It depends. Who of you knows how many clubs are in Moscow area community?
Seven.
You could see them in your agendas. Here we see World Surfers and six another clubs. Okay. It appears that to organize all meetings of all the seven clubs within Moscow area community, we need one usable tree. And what is one usable tree? It is a tree which we use to produce printing paper. Is it a big number? For Moscow, it's not, I think. But let's remember that in Toastmasters International, we have more than 16,000 clubs. Thus, we need to consume a lot of trees to organize our meetings. And could we reduce these costs? Of course we could. And now I'll explain what we need to do. In our club, the first step was done by our ex-president Paul Kapti, who decided to launch our club's Telegram channel. In this channel, Paul made live translations of our meetings, and also he posted our agendas. Thus, everyone in the audience could open his messenger and download the agenda and receive all the necessary information. Thus, why we need to print this agenda if we could use electronic ones? For me, I have smartphone with this agenda. Who of you have smartphones or tablets or notebooks? Raise your hands, guys. I think almost everyone in the audience could use electronic agendas, and this could save us almost 40% of our handouts costs. Unfortunately, in his last post, Paul told us that he couldn't maintain the channel further due to his Moscow area duties. Now he is Moscow area officer. That's why I proposed to our current president, Anton, to follow Paul's initiative and to maintain this channel in the future. Okay, and what could we do with the other handouts? Well, in the beginning of this year, I dedicated some time researching the topic of using messengers in marketing researches. And it appeared that there are super applicable for managing surveys. Thus, we could organize surveys in our clubs. And actually, every meeting we have almost three of them. We survey all the audience about their opinion of the speaker's presentations using speaker evaluation form. Also, we normally survey the audience about table topic winner with table topic ballot. And the third one, we normally survey the audience about do they like a meeting or not with meeting evaluation form. Thus, let's give feedback to our speakers via messengers. Here I put our current speaker evaluation form, and here is a speaker evaluation survey prototype which I made for this meeting using Telegram Messenger. What we see here? We see evaluation criteria, ranking, and comments. Thus, everyone in the audience could choose a speaker and evaluate him according to this evaluation criteria, writing rank and leaving his comment regarding about each criteria. The same way, we could choose a table topic winner. Instead of filling in his name in this form, we could write his name in the messenger. For me, I truly like to write myself as a table topic winner in this slide. Okay, and the last one is a form for evaluating a meeting. Here we see the same situation as the form of speaker evaluation. For speaker evaluation, we see different criteria, which are role takers and meeting, and we evaluate each of them according to these criteria, and we see what mean each criteria. Thus, we use a messenger and a keyboard with these ratings and its explanation. Do you think it could be better for our meeting or not? I think that using electronic devices is better because our modern generation lives with these gadgets all the time. And we have many benefits from using these applications. For example, the main benefit. Using messengers, we could save at least 94% of our handout costs. I calculated this number based on amount of papers which we could make electronically and the amount which we couldn't. Also, for those who are with Greenpeace members, using messengers within Toastmasters community, we could save more than 2,000 trees. It's a little forest for me, isn't it? And of course, what about money? We spend some money to printing paper, to ink, and to other attributes. But if we save 94% of this money, we could invest them in different things. For example, we could buy presents for our contest winners. Yes, Anton?
Yeah, exactly.
Or we could make presents when our members have birthdays. It's a great idea, I think. Presents for every member. And also, we can buy more cookies, more waters, more fruits. Thus, let's add a pinch of innovation to our meetings and let's save forests, and we'll be cool. This was the presentation of my proposal, and now I'm ready to answer your questions if you have them. Nice. Do you have a question?
Actually, I do.
Ask me, please.
I was thinking about the idea that you proposed that we should use smartphones at our meetings. But what about our general rule that we actually should avoid using them and should try to switch them off as soon as possible when the meeting starts? How do you handle that?
We could mute them and use our messengers in mute mode.
Yeah, well, I also have a question. What's about the penetration of the messengers around the auditory? Do all of them have the messengers, and how easy to enforce people to use? Because, for example, Telegram is still have a lot of room to for increase of.
Okay, actually, it's a topic for my next research. In my proposal, I recommend to use messengers in general, and I don't say that you should use Telegram or WhatsApp or Skype or something else. And the next step in this topic, which I plan to do, is to make a short research within Toastmasters community regarding to the messengers which are most of use. And then we could define one or two and make programs to automate our meetings. Okay?
I have a question. You talking about the public rooms when everyone see everyone else. So when everyone make an evaluation of someone, everyone see your evaluation, including the person whom you evaluate. What do you think about it? Will it be an issue?
Could you reformulate?
Okay, another point. When we do evaluation now, we write on a piece of paper, we wrap it up, give it a person.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody knows our evaluation. Here everybody see and now our evaluation.
Mm-hmm. When we talk about high technologies, we almost have no constraints in what we should or we could program. Thus, when we do our evaluation, or for example, when we choose our table topic winner, everyone in the audience write a name, and our secretary press a button or enter a comment in her messenger, and the messenger will tell her the name of the winner, the most frequently met name. It's my idea.
Can you program it?
Okay, I think that's all for the evening. Last, Mrs. Toastmaster.
Yeah.